track of all the cards that have been played. If you bet on a card that has all been played out, then anybody who's participating can take your bet off that card. So you want to make sure that, you know, you want to watch. We're just assuming that you're going to be here for hours and you're going to go through game after game after game. You know how to do it real fast, right? So that's what we're talking about. So what you're going to do is bet on one of these cards to win. If you want to bet on the card to lose, you can put a copper on top of it. Have you ever heard of coppering your bet?
No.
You can put a copper on it, and so that means you're betting on that card to lose. That might be complicated for the first time. And you use your marker on top of your bet to make sure that nobody else tries to take your money when you get paid.
Okay.
And now you're going to bet one of these denominations, 5, 10, or 25, and put your marker on top of it.
Oh, I see.
Okay. And suits do not make any difference in Faro at all.
Okay, so that's 6, 8.
And the dealer turns over two cards at once, and the first card is the losing card, usually. If you're on that card, she'll take your money. If the second card is the winning card, and if you're on that card, she pays you what you bet. It's very simple. Okay.
So, well, okay, so
the Faro game, the more the merrier.
But yep, what if it's neither the losing card or the winning card?
You just let it ride, or you can move your bet.
She's honest.
Okay. Yeah. So each set of winning and losing is called a turn. So in between each turn, you can move your bet, add to it. You can bet more than once.
Okay.
So, all right, are you ready to go? Okay, the first losing card is a jack. And the first winning card is five. And you're on neither. So we don't have any action. You can add bets. And if you want to get action on every turn, you can bet on the hot card. And what you're betting when you do that is that the winning card will be a higher denomination than the losing card. And so that'll happen every time.
Oh my gosh, we played something like that. We called it something
different. Yeah. Did you? Not Faro?
No, but it's similar, yeah.
Wait, so there's a losing. That's the winning card. That's the high card. And I can bet on the losing. This is losing.
And if you want to, you're doing it all. That's great.
Why not?
Wow.
Faro.
Okay, so.
Aces
okay,
are one.
So kings are already, there's one king already out.
This is a jack.
Oh, a jack. Already out. So
there's three left.
That's how you're keeping track.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, here we go. Losing card is a four. Winning card is a two.
So that means I bet the high card.
And you bet that the winning card would be higher than the losing card.
Oh, so I lost that.
So I guess you bet. But keep them going. When everybody in those days knew how to play Faro, so it was a very fast-moving game. Mm-hmm. Fast, fast. We're going to go with losing card is an ace. Winning card is a king.
Ace beats king, right?
No, ace is a one.
Yes. Yeah. So all right. I'm going to try it.
Ace is a one.
Mm-hmm.
So this is.
So that was, I bet he got some higher.
Okay.
But I mean,
you'll be special.
The shoes, you know. No, it's the only one. Let's say it's not an ace, it's a one.
Okay.
And that's all you have there. It's a one.
Are these real? Are these old?
It's not an antique. I made the board myself. Hi there.
Hi.
Have you played Faro before?
No.